Namaste. Welcome to the lecture series on the subject Basic Thermodynamics, Module 3, Part 2, Entropy, Lecture Number 9. Myself, Dr. N. Satish Kumar, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Canara Engineering College, Bantwal. So the contents for this topic is Clausius inequality. So entropy definition, entropy, yes, because it is a symbol for entropy, is a property of system such that its increase S2 minus S1 as the system changes from state 1 to state 2 is given by S2 minus S1 is equal to integration from 1 to 2 delta Q by T for the reversible process. Right, so this is the definition of the entropy. It's a property which increases by an amount of S2 minus S1 as the changes, state changes from state 1 to 2. In differential form, this equation 1 can be written as ds, because S2 minus S1 you can write it as ds is equal to del Q by T. Total entropy is denoted by capital letter S, and specific entropy is denoted by small letter S, because entropy per unit mass is nothing but the specific entropy. Now let us come to the topic of this lecture, that is the Clausius inequality. When any system undergoes a cyclic process, the cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than or equal to 0. See, this is for any process. When any system undergoing a cyclic process, the cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than or equal to 0. So in mathematical form, you can write it as cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than or equal to 0. Now we have to prove this, where del Q is an infinitesimal heat transfer and T is the absolute temperature of part of the system to which heat transfer delta Q occurs. Okay, so delta Q is infinitesimal heat transfer, and that T is the temperature at which this heat transfer takes place. Like that you can understand that. Now you have to prove this. Already we discussed the reversible cycle and we studied the Clausius theorem in the lecture number 8. So for any reversible cycle, from Clausius theorem we have the expression cyclic integral of del Q by T for reversible process is equal to 0. Your suffix R after the cyclic integral sign indicates that it is a reversible cycle. So it is equal to 0. That is, we proved in the last lecture. So from the Carnot theorem, we know that the efficiency of an irreversible engine is always less than the efficiency of a reversible engine. So efficiency of the reversible engine is the maximum efficiency possible, right? So that is why it is taken as the standard. So efficiency of any other engine, which is irreversible engines, usually all other engines are irreversible engines, so its efficiency will be less than the efficiency of the reversible engine. Okay, now substituting for eta I and eta R. So eta I is nothing but the efficiency of the irreversible engine. So that you can write it as 1 minus del QL by del QH for irreversible engine. Suffix I indicates for irreversible engine. And for efficiency of reversible engine is 1 minus del QL by del QH for reversible. Suffix R. So here del QL this and del QH of this is nothing but the heat rejected and absorbed by the irreversible engine, whereas this quantity del QL and del QH are the heat absorbed and removed and absorbed by the reversible cycle. And all of us know that for a reversible cycle or a reversible engine, the efficiency can also be expressed in terms of temperature. That means 1 minus del QL by del QH for reversible cycle is also equal to 1 minus TL by TH, and this is true only for the reversible cycle. So what you can do is, here the right hand side of the above expression 2 you can replace by 1 minus TL by TH. So this is what is done here. So right hand side only replaced. Now here no need to suffix write suffix R, because this TL and TH is common for both the cycles or both the engines. So reversible and irreversible, so they operate between the same two reservoirs. The temperature of the source is TH and the sink is TL. Only thing is the amount of heat absorbed and removed are different. Okay, try to understand this. So there is no need to suffix R for this. It is just 1 minus TL by TH. Now here 1 gets cancelled. So it is minus of this quantity is less than minus of this quantity. That is minus of del QL by del QH is equal to, sorry, less than minus of TL by TH. Now if I change the sign, if I make positive both sides, so it becomes greater than, you can see here. So here it was less than. Now if I change the sign, like I'll show an example, minus 2 minus 4, okay, I'll write minus 4 is less than minus 2. All of you know. Now if I change the sign, this becomes 4, okay, this becomes 2. Now it is not less than, now it is greater than. So when you change the sign, so automatically the sign changes, you can see here. So previously it was less than, now it has become greater than. Now here next part, so it is taken the reciprocal. So instead of del QL by del QH, it is written del QH by del QL. Now again the sign changes. So I will show you one by one more example. Suppose if I write 1 by 4, so 1 by 4 is less than 1 by 2, all of you know. Now if I take the reciprocal, 1 by 4 becomes 4 and 1 by 2 becomes 2. Now this is not less than, now it is greater than, 4 is greater than 2. So when I take the reciprocal as well as when I change the sign, so the here inequality sign also changes. Less than becomes greater than becomes less than, okay. Now just manipulation of this or reiterating of this equation, del QH by TH is brought to here. So that is here del QH by TH for, now del QH is for irreversible engine, so suffix I outright, minus, okay, this brought this side, minus of del QL by TL, again that is for irreversible cycle. Now use the sign convention for the positive for absorption and negative for the heat rejection. So then we get, so this term as positive here, because minus of minus is plus, so that I will write in the next slide. So taking the sign convention, so heat rejected is negative, previous equation, previous slide, so it was negative in the beginning, so minus into minus is plus, so this is what you can write for a irreversible cycle, that is del QH by TH for irreversible engine plus del QL by TL for irreversible engine is less than 0. So from this we see that the algebraic sum of the ratios of the amounts of heat transferred to the absolute temperature for a cyclic irreversible process is always less than 0. So this is what we proved is for the irreversible process. That means in short you can write as cyclic integral of del Q by T for irreversible engine is less than 0. Now if you combine the equations 1 and 6. So 1, what we wrote, cyclic integral of del Q by T for reversible engine is equal to 0, which we proved in the last lecture. Now combining these two, so we can write that cyclic integral of del Q by T is always less than or equal to 0. That means if it is equal to 0, it is a reversible cycle. If it is less than 0, it is a irreversible cycle. So this is one way of finding or checking the reversibility of a cycle also. So this is known as the Clausius inequality. So a very important proof you have to know. Okay. Now Clausius inequality is helpful in determining whether the process is reversible or not. So that is what I told in the previous slide. If cyclic integral of del Q by T is 0, the cycle is reversible. If the cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than 0, the cycle is irreversible and possible. If cyclic integral of del Q by T is greater than 0, the cycle is impossible since it violates the second law of thermodynamics. So this is a very important concept you have to remember. to identify a process is reversible, irreversible, or impossible. Okay, now let us illustrate this Clausius inequality through few examples. Example 1, consider the heat flow from the reservoir at temperature T1 to that at T2 across the conductor. So you can see here, okay, if I can draw a line here, no problem, if you don't draw all those. Now this you can take it as high temperature reservoir, this you can take it as low temperature reservoir. So heat flows from high temperature reservoir to the low temperature reservoir through this conductor. So conductor you have to take it as a system now. Okay, so conductor at one point place it absorbs heat from the high temperature reservoir, so at other place it rejects heat to the low temperature reservoir. So let del Q1 is 1000, so this quantity we will take it as 1000 kilojoules, and the temperature of the source is 500 and temperature of the sink as 250. Now since del Q1, you see, now I took the conductor as a system, so system is absorbing from T1 by an amount of del Q1 which is 1000 kilojoules, same amount is given to the sink at T2, so del Q2 also becomes same quantity, but it becomes its minus because as a conductor, as a system, it is rejecting this heat. Now if I write the summation of del Q by T or cyclic integral of del Q by T for this system, so it is 1000 by 500, that is del Q1 by T1 plus del Q2 by T2, since del Q2 is minus, so it is minus 1000 by 250, so I will get minus 2.5 kilojoules per kg per kilojoules per Kelvin, sorry. Okay, now here, so this quantity is negative. What does it indicate? So it is less than zero, since it is an irreversible process, because heat can never flow from the low temperature reservoir to high temperature reservoir through the same conductor, you cannot do that. So hence it is an irreversible process. So irreversible process, the quantity of cyclic integral of del Q by T is less than zero, so you proved that it is less than zero. So this is one of the examples. Now let us take one more example. So here E is the system. Okay, this is a E, that is engine. Okay, you can call it as engine, is a system which executes a cycle process. Now here it is given, it is absorbing 1000 from 500 Kelvin and converting part of that into work and rejecting the remaining into the sink. So what you can find out, delta W also you can find out here, 1000 minus 600, that is 400, but that is not our interest here. Okay, now the sink temperature is 250 Kelvin. Now let us calculate first the cyclic integral of del Q by T or summation of del Q by T. So 1000 is Q1, at T1 is 500, so 1000 by 500, since heat is rejected by the system, this 600 becomes minus and it is at 250, so you will get minus 0.4 kilojoules per Kelvin. That means this becomes an irreversible engine. However, if E were a reversible engine, suppose if you consider E as the irreversible, reversible engine, then work delta W would have been, suppose if you, it's a reversible engine, okay, then delta W, so it is given here, QH into TH minus TL by TH. Because for a reversible cycle, the efficiency is delta W by QH, which is nothing but TH minus TL by TH. So using this formula, so you can find out what is delta W. So delta W is 500. If delta W is 500, then QL becomes 500. So in that case, the cyclic integral of del Q by T becomes 1000 by 500 minus 1000 minus 500. So QL now, QL, that is this quantity here, QL, now it becomes work, 1000 is the input minus W. So 1000, now just now we found that delta W is 500. So delta W is 500. So 1000 here, if you carefully observe, 1000 minus delta W 500, which is the 500 just now you calculated. So it becomes 1000 minus 500. And divided by 250, so it becomes zero. So what it indicates, right? So this is for the reversible cycle. Now this is what I calculated for the irreversible cycle. Now if it was a very reversible engine, So then from here you have to do this first calculation. Okay, delta W we can calculate first, because delta W by QH is the efficiency formula, which is also equal to TH minus TL by TH. So actually this QH is brought from here, denominator of this efficiency formula. So I hope all of you can understand that. So you can find out delta W. If it were a reversible engine, delta W would have been 500. If delta W would have been 500, QL would have been also 500, because 1000 minus 500. So that is what you substitute here, 1000 minus 500 for QL. Yes, substituted here. You can see here. So then you get 0. You see, that is 0. So it is equal to or less than 0. If it is a reversible cycle, it is equal to 0. If it is an irreversible cycle, it is less than 0. So this is how you have to prove the Clausius inequality. Now, example 3, a heat engine receives reversibly 420 kilojoules of heat from source 327 degrees Celsius and rejects to a sink at 27 degrees Celsius. So it is operating between two reservoirs. One is at 327 degrees Celsius and the sink is at 27 degrees Celsius, and the heat engine is absorbing 420 kilojoules per cycle of heat. There is no other heat transfer. For such an hypothetical for each of the three hypothetical amounts of heat rejected in A, B, C below, compute the cyclic integral of del Q by T. Okay, he has given three hypothetical amounts of heat transfer. Let us see where is it is given. Okay, from these results, show that which case is irreversible, which is reversible, and which is impossible. So he has given three cases. Look at here. A is 210 kilojoules per cycle. That is what rejected, QL. All the three amounts are QL, because QH is given here, 420. Three engines you have to assume now. Three hypothetical cases of heat rejection. One is 210, one is 105, and one is 315. And which of the case is irreversible, which of the case is reversible, and which is impossible, you have to find out. Okay, we'll do that one by one. Okay, the first case, so this is common, 420 kilojoules per cycle. Source temperature is 600 is same. Sink temperature is 300 is also same for all the three cases. In the first case, let us consider that heat rejection is 210 kilojoules per cycle. Substitute in the expression summation of del Q by T. So 420 by 600 minus 210 by 300. So this case is the reversible cycle. So here it delivers maximum amount of work, right? So it is a cyclic integral of del Q by T is equal to 0. Now if you go to the second case, case B, here the rejected quantity is 105. This is same. This is the sink temperature, source temperature, sink temperature, everything remains same. If you substitute, you will get plus 0.35. Now you can see that the quantity is more than 0. That means the summation of del Q by T or cyclic integral of del Q by T is greater than 0. That is, irrespective, if you can see 420 is applied, only 105 is rejected. That means maximum is converted into work around 315. 315 is converted into work. So it is a high efficiency. So, and as per this, so it is crossing the Carnot efficiency also. So that is why you got this as positive, and which is impossible. So you cannot construct a engine like this. So that is why it is called as a hypothetical. Now coming to the third case, case C, here 315 is rejected. Okay. Now itself I can say that 420, 315 is rejected, only 105 is converted into work. I will say now itself it is a possible engine. Let us check. So 420, okay, and 315 temperatures substitution. So you will get minus 0.35. That means the summation of del Q by T is less than 0. So it is irreversible engine and it is a possible engine. You see, all irreversible engines are possible in this world, because it has got a efficiency less than the maximum possible efficiency of the reversible cycle or the Carnot efficiency. So this is how you can check whether the engine is irreversible, reversible, or impossible. Okay, thank you. So with this I conclude this lecture number 9, and we will continue with the lecture number 10 in the next class. Okay, thank you.